Today I'm going to show you how easy it is to create Doodle videos. Now, if you don't know what Doodle videos are those videos where you see the images, where you see text lines, and you see a hand drawing those pictures, or where you see a hand drawing the text line. Today I'll be reviewing Doodleoze, the software that you're seeing here in the background that allows you to create videos like that very, very easily. Now, before I do so, I want to mention that there is a link in the description of this video. It will redirect you to my website where you can find more information about Doodleoze, also about the pricing. Here at the left side, you can see that it starts the personal version for $27 and the commercial for $37. There's more information when you click on these buttons, you can see the funnel. And I also want to mention, if you pick this up through my link, you will also get all the bonuses here that I mentioned here on my website completely free. And the only thing that you have to do is simply purchase Doodleoze through this button on my website. All right, let me show you what Doodleoze is all about and how you can create videos like this. So I already played a bit with this software, and let me show you a quick preview what I created in a few minutes. So when I click on preview here, you can see here in hand, which says maybe you're a business owner, or maybe you're a plumber or a chiropractor. And you see the hand drawing this, and then comes the next slide. One thing they all love is food. Well, this video obviously does not make any sense. It's just to show you a little bit of the software, how easy it is to create videos like this. So what you just saw were two slides that I created within Doodleoze. And let me show you how it works. So here at the left top here, you can see that this is selected. So this is my first slide. And when I click on the second slide here, you can see this is the second slide with the food. Now, on each slide that you create, you can add your own images, you can add your own text, etc. So let me simply create a new project. I don't have to save this. I'm going to call this test. I'm going to click on create. So this is when you open Doodleoze, this is what you will see. And it works really easy. Here at the left side, you have a block where you can choose from different options. So you can add text to your video. You could add Doodle to your video. And those two will be the most used, I think. You can add bitmap images. You can add videos to your Doodleoze videos as well. Animated GIFs, audio, and you can close the canvas. But let me show you how it works. So first of all, when you're going to start, you're going to click on this big plus button here to create a new scene. So you can add a scene from your personal library if you have a scene created. In this case, we're going to create a new scene. So in this scene, you can add your text. So when I click here on this text button, you can see that automatically the text has been added here to my screen. Now let me move myself to the left, because here at the right side, you can modify everything. So here you can see the text and you can change it to whatever you want. So are you a business owner? So here you can change this. You can also change the colors. You can change the font size, as you can see. You can also layer your images. So if you have multiple images on top of each other, you can move them to the top or to the bottom. And it's a bit small. I understand that this is small, but I cannot zoom in this software for this review. So let me do it this way. But you can see here that you have some options. And once you have added an element to your video, the only thing that you need to do is here, go to the laptop, you can click on this icon and you can add a new effect. And from here, you have the option to add a sketch by hand. So when I do sketch by hand, what happens is now you can see that here the timeline became bigger. And this is the time frame that the hand will draw this text. So this is almost 4 seconds. And if I want to make this 5 seconds, I can drag this to 5 seconds. As you can see, it will now take 5 seconds for the hand to draw. Are you a business owner? So you can also preview this. You can close this canvas here. And then when you do that, you can see it automatically starts. Are you a business owner? You see the preview, or you can also click here on the top on preview, and then it will create a preview of all of your slides. So this is the first one. As you can see, it's super easy to do, and you can add multiple elements. So we're going to open the canvas again. And then from the menu here, instead of text, we're going to add a doodle. So when we click on add doodle, we have the option here to search in a library of images. So let's say I want to have characters in this video, then I can use them here. So I could do, are you Superman? And then I do Superman in here. It's something like, well, he doesn't have the Superman cape on, but it's just for this example purpose. Well, let's keep it this way. Are you a business owner? So you have multiple options, because remember that we added the effect to are you a business owner? We added that effect here by clicking on this icon. Now we can do exactly the same for this image. So when I click on this icon, I can add a new effect, and I can also say, I want to fly this in, for example, or I want to fly in by hand. So when I do fly in by hand, what now happens is this, look at this, are you a business owner? And then the hand comes in. Now, as you can see, the hand came way too early because it was still writing at the top. So see this top here, what you're seeing here is a timeline editor. So within this editor, we're going to drag, for example, this fly by hand, and we want to add this person in here, this Superman or this super businessman. We want to move this to the right so that when the sketch over has ended by writing this text, then we want to add the super businessman inside of the picture. So when we move this and we're going to preview this again, now it's going to write, and then the hand comes in at the end. Look at this. Boom. Are you a business owner? And this goes a bit slow. So we're going to change this to half of the size, so it goes twice as fast. So when we preview this again, we can also do the writing faster. And then we're going to move this here. Now we're going to preview this. Look at this. Now the hand goes much quicker. Boom. You see that? And this could be your first scene. And then you can go to your next scene and create a new scene, which has a new blank canvas. And you can switch scenes. So let's add a doodle in here as well. So let's do a building from the library. And let's take this one. So a colored one. There are also colored ones in here. And we can make this bigger in here. Are you a businessman? And then we also going to add text in this slide as well. But we want to draw this. I think this is a cool one to draw. So again, here we're going to sketch. And you can do sketch by hand or without a hand. But let's say we want to sketch by hand. Now we've added the effect to this slide. And then also here at the right top, you have choose hands. So you also have the option to choose different hands. So there are different kind of hands. There are businessman hands. There are all different kinds of hands, different colors hands. And you can simply choose whatever hand you would like. So if you want to use another one, you simply choose the other hand. And now the other hand will be used for this picture. And you can choose a hand for each specific picture inside of a slide. And then again, we can add text again here at the top. And we can, let's say we want to fly in this text. What we're going to do, we're going to add a new effect, and then we're going to fly this in. Or maybe we want to do this differently. They're also kinetic, so let's do that. Slide from left, or skew from left long, skew from left. Let's see. Well, skew from left long. Let's see how that will look like. And let's preview. So you can preview this when you close the canvas here. Boom. Do you see? The text jumps in. And if we want to preview everything, we're going to go to the top here. Are you a business owner? Then the hand comes and boom, it goes to the second slide. As you can see here, it's drawn the second picture. And I think this looks really, really good. Now, within the slides, you can open a canvas. You can add a doodle. Just this is what I just showed you. You can get more images. You can also upload your own images from your computer. You need to have SVG images. And if you don't know what SVG is, you can Google for it. There are a lot of images that you can get from the internet as well that you can use inside of Doodleoze. And you can upload them inside of this software. There are also bitmap images, so you can add from local storage or from your Pixabay. You can add video as well. So if you want to add a video, you can do that as well. One of the upgrades is a Pixabay and Pexels integration so that you can implement those videos. Or you could add them from a library from your computer. You can upload this. But let me just pick a video so that I can show you how this works. So right now it's implementing this video for me. It's loading the video. And I can add this video to the background of my slides so that the video will play. So you can import your own videos in here. So I'm going to say add, and now I'm going to add this to the top here. And as you can see here, I need to move this to the background. So in this case, we go to the right here and we're going to say move down. And let me see here, move on bottom. Let me see, am I doing this correctly? I thought it was here. Let me check. Yeah, I think I just need to play the video. I'm not sure why this is not at the bottom here right now. Maybe I need to add an effect. Oh, it should work. Let me check out the preview here. Open canvas. Yeah, you see here the video plays in the background. So maybe I need to add my text to the front. Let me open the canvas again. Let me see here. Now, I'm not sure why this is. There is a possibility to add a video to the background, and maybe I need to do it this way because I should play this video here at the left side, something like this, and then add the text here because you're also able to add video in a slide. So when I close this canvas in here, I also have the possibility in here to do an animated background. So I can also do a scene background video. So probably I should have added the video with this option here at the left side to add a video here so that I can add it as a background to this scene. But as you can see here, there are a lot of options as well in this whole left screen. So when you close your canvas, you have all the other extra options in here. So you could do an animated background. You could do a video background. You could do a GIF background. You could do a scene voiceover. There are more possibilities. You can add music to your video. That's here on the top here where you can see audio. The text, you can change the text in here again. So you can align this left. You can center this. You could do all different kind of things. You could change the colors in here. But also the cool thing is the slide. So when I go to the first slide, I can also say the effects in the slide. I want to, let me see where that is. Draw on a previous slide. You can do that. That's not what I was looking for. Because you could also set effects in the scene. Let me see where that is. Let me pause the video. Okay, I found it. It's here in the scene here at the top. I could scroll in here. I didn't notice that. But after a scene here, let me zoom in. It says action after scene. So when a scene, so these slides, you can also call it scenes. When a scene is over, let me go to the first slide again. You could say, I want to shift up or shift down, or I want to shift left or shift right, or I want to circle in. Here you could do all different kind of effects to the slides. So you could do lots of circles. So when I do lots of circles in here, when I play the video, it will do the circles to go to the next video. I'm not sure if you're going to see this on a wide video, but boom, do you see that? Lots of circles, and that will be the transition. And you can also extend the scene. So let's say you have a voiceover over your first slide and you want to add extra seconds at the end of a slide. You can simply drag this slider to add extra frames to the end of a scene. So when I put this, for example, on 83 or let's say 151 frames, look what happens when I preview this. When this first slide is done, look at this. Now it's going to wait longer until it shows the next slide. Do you see that? It's going to wait those 150 frames before it shows the second slide. So this is how easy it is to create these videos for you. And like I said, there are a lot of effects here that you can choose from. You can draw on the previous slide, etc. And once you're done here, you can add a new slide, create a new scene, and then you can start working on your next scene. So you could do a new doodle again. You could do add banners, but you could also add, let me see, arrows, for example. If you want to add arrows, oh, there's animals, not arrows. Here are the arrows. If you want to add these arrows, you could do that as well here by adding them here. And then the arrow will be drawn. And you can add another doodle. So if you want to add a boy here, you're going to do this. And then the boy will be in here. You get the idea, right? And once you're done, you can export your project. And you can export this to a video and you can upload it to your social media networks, etc. But this is how easy it is to work with Doodleoze. Now, Doodleoze works on your desktop computer, so it's not cloud-based. You need to install it on your computer. It's Windows-based, it's Mac-based, so you can use it on both, on Mac and Windows. It's very easy to install. And yeah, probably there are some more options, but this is quickly how it works to show you a quick preview of how easy it is to create those Doodle videos. Now, if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below. And again, there is a link in the description of this video. It will redirect you to my website, where you're also going to get my bonuses, where you can see the pricing, etc., and where you can get Doodleoze. So yeah, if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please consider to do so. I do a lot of product reviews on a daily basis. Hit that subscribe button, the notification bell, so that you get notified. And also, please hit that thumbs up button to help my video to boost in the search results in YouTube. I would appreciate that. And thank you so much for watching. And I hope to see you in my next review. Talk soon. Bye-bye.